You're sitting at your desk. You know it's time to go. You've said that to yourself over a million times. But this time you know, for sure, is real. You're tired. You're just so very tired. Your parents pissed you off. Like school wasn't bad enough today. You go to get the rope, or the knife, or the gun, or just whatever you choose to use because you're that desperate to leave. You're ready. You think of it as some game. The first one dead is the first one who wins. No one's home. It's the perfect time. You're ready. If you don't do it now, you're just gonna look down on yourself even more forever. You're gonna hate yourself even more. No one knows. No one will know. Until later on. Instead of getting a paper and a pen, you get the video camera along with a chair. You're standing on the chair. You decide to go with the rope. You're gone instantly, and there'll be no noise. One side of the rope is tied to the top of your fan, while the other is already around your neck. You're in tears, and you know it's for real this time. You can feel it. You turn on the video camera, and you just stare at that red light blinking upon your eyes. You start to mumble out a few words. Mom and Dad, I'm sorry. I don't know why I'm sorry, but I'm sorry. I just can't do this anymore. I don't even know who I am anymore. I've lost myself, and I seem to not be able to find my way back. Please don't blame yourself, please. I love you both. Please tell my siblings the same. Stay strong and stay safe. I'll see you all soon. You say sorry to your best friend because you know you won't be there for him anymore. Especially when he needs you more than ever. You say sorry to everyone you can think of. Even yourself. You're sorry for not being strong anymore. You're sorry for breaking down. You're sorry for putting them through so much pain in their life. You stare, once again, at the red light blinking upon your eyes. One foot is off the chair now, as you begin to mouth the word goodbye. You have the remote control to turn off the camera in your right hand. Your pointer finger on the off button already. You click that button, and as soon as you see that light go off, you go off. Both feet are now off the chair. That chair is on the floor. The room is filled with silence. You're dead. You're gone. There's no going back. Everything is over. You don't have to live in pain anymore. But everyone else will. What are your parents gonna think? What about your little brother or your little sister? What are they gonna do? You're gone. You're dead. There's no going back. You ended your life because the person you liked only thought of you as a friend? You ended your life because that one teacher was harder on you than anyone else in the class because she knew that you were the only one that is going somewhere in life. Your parents are home now. They call your name. Telling you that they're home, just like they normally do whenever they get home. But something's different. You don't answer. They don't hear your voice. They get worried. You always answer. They come upstairs thinking you're sleeping or showering. Your mom opens your bedroom door and screams at the top of her lungs. She instantly passes out. Your little sister hears her and comes up after her. She screams, "Daddy, help!" She runs over to you, hitting your leg, begging you to wake up. "Wake up! Wake up! Please stop! Wake up!" But you don't answer. You're not waking up. You're gone. You're dead. There's no waking up. There's no going back. Your dad comes running upstairs and all he could do is stare. He watches his baby girl swing back and forth on a rope. He sees the video camera and he sees the chair. But he doesn't move. He's stiff as a board. He cries. Your dad never cries. He picks up the phone and calls 911. He can barely get the words, "My daughter committed suicide," out of his mouth. He's in tears. Your little sister stares at your dad. He hangs up and she jumps right into your daddy's arms, crying harder than ever. She's too young to understand completely, but she knows you're gone. She knows you're dead and she knows that you're never coming back. Everything is over. The cops finally arrive. They take your mom out of your room. They push your dad and sister out of your room. And now they're sitting in the living room. They take your body down off those ropes and lay you on the stretcher. They cover your body and out you go. Just like that. In the blink of an eye, everything happened and everything was over. You're gone. You're dead. There is no going back. Nothing is the same. 2 weeks have passed and your mom still stares out the window more than half of the day. Sometimes even the whole day. Your little sister still hasn't returned to school. Your dad was forced to go to work so he could pay all the bills for your wake and your funeral. Eventually, they found the strength to go back into your room. Your door hasn't been open for 2 months. The rope is still laying on the floor, the same place the cops put it, and the video camera is still sitting on the table. They don't even dare to watch that video. It will never be seen. They slowly pick up the ropes and throw it in the garbage. Chills run up their spine, your mom basically in tears. They brush off your bed, making it neat, like they used to do every morning after you went to school. Your desk was empty. It didn't have those little sticky notes you used to leave before you ran to the bus saying, "Have a good day, Mom. Remember to smile." Or, "Have fun at work, Dad." Smiley face. You pretended to be so happy. You even tricked yourself. Your bed was made and your room was clean. They shut the door and it remained shut. Your school is still in distress. You thought no one cared and you thought no one noticed you. Remember that girl that said no to being your lab partner? Yeah, she cuts every single night now because she thinks it's her fault that you died. Remember that boy that tripped you by accident, looked at you and just didn't say sorry? Yeah, he's in suicidal therapy 5 days a week in the hospital because he feels a smile could have saved your life and he didn't give that to you. Do you remember that teacher that was hard on you that day? She quit her job because she felt she wasn't suited to teach anymore. You're gone, you're dead. There's no going back. 4 years have passed now. Your little sister is now 15 years old. She started a club. It's in her school dedicated to you. Secrets is what she calls it. The club is formed for kids to speak their hearts without anyone judging them. They could say anything they want to and talk about anything they needed to. If they were suicidal, They always had someone to talk to. That was your problem. You didn't want to talk to anyone. You had everything bottled inside of you. You acted as if you were the happiest kid on the planet, and you acted as if you had the perfect life. You played that happy character so well that even you started to believe it. You would be so happy all day, and as soon as you laid in bed that night, the thoughts came back. A little fight between you and your parents could have set you off. But with everything inside of you bottled up for years, you just hit your limits. You're gone. You're dead. There's no going back. Your room will never be occupied. Your mom still cries every single night. Your dad isn't as strong as he used to be. Your little sister will never grow up with you by her side, moving her in the right direction. She needed you. Your best friend is still torn up. He needed you. Your parents don't know what to do anymore. They needed you. Your school now has a club dedicated to you, so teens will not make the same mistake as you did. Your life was precious, and you took it away in the blink of an eye. All you needed was a smile. It's all you needed to show you that everything will be okay. But since you're gone, just know people cared. People always have cared. And people always will care. You were just way too upset to see that back then. You were just too caught up in the fact that you thought no one cared. When the truth was, more people cared about you than you ever thought they would. And you know what sucks? It sucks that you see that now that you're gone, and you didn't see that when you were still here. Your town will never be the same. A girl is gone. A special girl. A girl who thought no one cared. Everyone cared. I promise you. They care.
Yo, I'm just here for the drinks. I just put you in here because your girlfriend works at the stripper club thing, and I just put you in here so it's because it's your birthday present, and I just want you to be happy. And I'm mostly here because they really make really good Starbucks coffee here. So I'm not here for looking at the girls dancing. I'm here for the coffee. Hang on. Oops. Up next is... Her name is Crystal. Actually, it's Natalie. My name is Natalie. Oops, sorry, my bad, Natalie. Okay, up next is Natalie. Thank you, Natalie.
Thank you, guys.
Wow, this is awesome, dude. What do you think? Even though I'm single, but she's kind of hot.
Thank you. Jason? Hi, Jason. I didn't know you were into this stripper thing.
You know this girl, Jason? Yeah, dude, you'd know her. Yeah, do you?
Me know her? No.
I don't know her. You guys are crazy. You guys think I actually know her?
Do I know you, miss? Do I know you? Your name is Jason Parker.
Oh my gosh. I've been having the greatest crush on you since high school.
And you just literally ignored me because you're just too shy and nervous.
Cause you talked to my friends and they said, why aren't you talking to her? And then I was like, what? And my friend's like, I think it's because he's shy and nervous around you. That's why he's acting so strange. And I was like, wow, that's probably because he likes me. And they're like, totally, yeah. Is that true, Jason?
Me like you, Natalie? I never said I liked you. Why would you say that I like you?
Why would you say I like you?
We're just friends since high school, and we graduated years ago. You know what I mean?
No. No. We still have school, silly. We still have school. And I'm totally... Are you gonna go to this prom with me next week? Are you? Are you gonna take me to the prom? Are you?
Dude, she just knocked over my coffee, bro. Really?
Seriously, you knocked over a coffee.
Ugh. Now I have to get a refund. Where is this lady over here? Oh, wait, it's you.
Oh, sorry. Sorry, I didn't mean to knock over your coffee. Let me just fix that. Sorry. Sorry.
And it's my birthday, and I want to have the greatest birthday ever, and you ruined it!
Oh, sorry. By the way, happy birthday.
Now you make me feel a lot better. Thank you.
Do you want me to get you some refund coffees? I'm gonna get you some refund coffees.
Actually, if you guys are dating and something, or if you start liking each other, I think you're okay. My coffee's okay. I'm fine.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, yep, me too. Oh, I'm glad we're brothers. Totally.
Yeah!
Ow, I hurt my ears.
Sorry, I'm just love Jason.
Excuse me? Wait, what?
I don't want to say this because it's so embarrassing, but I have a lot of posters in my room.
That's not creepy, and why?
Because he's the best guy in the whole guy that I have a crush on. Well, we used to be dating, and then he broke me up because of this other girl he likes, and he's in love with this other girl, and I was like, what? He's cheating.
My name's Cameron.
And I'm gay. This is my story.
One day I came home from school.
My mom and dad came in my room. They started yelling at me because of school. Because my grades were getting too low.
Science, you went to a B to an F, and then the same with math. You went from a C to a D.
Listen, Mom, Dad, I couldn't think straight during a test.
This child.
It's the first day my mom and dad physically abused me. 4 years later, I'm in high school. And people find out that I was gay. Well, I am gay, actually. I started getting bullied for it. You gay faggot. I just go die in a hole. Hey, don't push me. What you gonna do about a nerd? Into one handsome guy. Stood up for me. Leave him alone. He didn't do anything to you, did he? Exactly. Now I'd go away if I were you.
Yeah.
We became best friends. I finally came through and told him that I was gay. I was really surprised because he told me he was gay too. Until one day at school, he asked me out, and I said yes. And so we did date, and of course my abusive mother and father still abused me. Till one day, I showed up at school with bruises and scratches all over my body. And, well, Brandon was curious of what happened to me. So I lied and told him I fell down my stairs. He obviously didn't believe me. What happened to you? I don't like seeing you like this. It was nothing. I fell down my stairs for the last time. Babe, don't keep this a secret from me. What happened to you? You know I care about you. And then I told him that I was getting abused since the 7th grade by my parents. He told me everything was going to be alright and that they would be taken care of. But to my disbelief, when I came back from home, from school, both of my parents were laying dead on the floor. Brandon right next to their dead bodies with a gun in his paw. He could see I was really happy of what happened. He told me it was for the best and that he loves me. And I told him that I loved him too. Soon later, I dyed my fur and got piercing. Brandon and I are still together and are a happy gay couple. And that's my story.
You're a ugly, disgusting piece of crap who does not have a dad. Oh my god. Really? Is like the little emo freak? Dude, why are you with her? Why do you even care? I don't care about your relationship because you guys don't know what love really is. You can call me emo if you talk bad about my boyfriend. It's a reason why I love him. He makes me feel special and happy. I love him for himself. I'm not making him mean or rude. He understands me and I understand him. When we first met on that sidewalk, I thought he was going to kill me, but he didn't. He saved me from two guys who tried to attack me, and saved me from his brother. He always been beside me, all the time. He stops me from cunning, but all the time he stops me. But I love him, and I would never trade him for anything in the world. Let's go. I guess I was just bored because, so I just made this little, I just made this for my friend Kelly Bunny Lps. She's the creator of Dakota Edwards, and her and mine role play with these two lovebirds. I don't have the Great Dane that's actually Dakota, but I use this one as him, so. Yeah. Oh, God. And I really hope you guys like this and enjoy this video. Hashtag Clota. And yes, before you guys say anything, Chloe does really cut herself. Yeah. Because of her disorders, Cuddly Bunny said, I would make a series about this, that might be a maybe. Anyway, bye my blood roses. P.S. Chloe still cuts herself now to this day. So, bye guys. Ugh.
Hey babe, want to fuck? Sure, come over, my parents aren't home. Hey, my dick is hard. Shove that monster up my ass, daddy. Ow, 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 oh fuck. I'm gonna come. Ow, 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 ow. Ow, 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 ow. I love you, Frank. I love you too, Gerard.
Ow! I stubbed my toe on this fucking bed. Do I smell blood? Because, you know, I love blood. What the fuck? Let me lick. What the hell? Don't fucking touch me. But blood pit lay is a thing. That sounds fucking disgusting. Let's do it. Yummy. Sunch kink. Hunty. Yummy. I love it. You should stub your toe more often. I fucking love this. Ow, I just fell. God, you're bleeding. I guess I am. Let's fuck, daddy. Oh, okay. Even though I have a serious injury and might die tonight, I want you to fuck me as hard as you can, daddy. Kinky. I have to call an ambulance. I'll fuck you in it. Kinky. Seriously, call an ambulance. Okay. Yummy. Bye. Time to go to the hospital.
Are you ready for your private session?
Yeah, let's start with some poses. Very good.
Are you single? Don't tell my boyfriend about this.
I guess you can say that.
Good.
Take your bow off.
Okay. Now you take your collar off.
Let me take a peek.
Okay.
Perfect for our magazine. Good, good girl. I think you have yourself sold.
Really?
Yep. My phone's ringing. No, I wasn't in bed with another stripper, I promise. I was washing the dishes at the house like you told me to. Okay, have fun at work. Hey girl, wake up. My girlfriend isn't home, so let's go while we can.
Okay.
Gotta get some turtles. That's what.
Yeah. What do you want?
I'm just looking for love and turtles.
Well, you come to the wrong place, but come on in anyway. I play Minecraft on the daily.
Wait, I think I love you now because you just said that.
Oh my god.
I think I found my true love. You want to go play Minecraft together? We'd love that.
Let's go play Minecraft, dude. I have computer version. Do you like which version do you like better? Like Xbox or computer? Like yeah.
Oh yeah, man. Oh yeah.
Hello.
Oh, you look a lot like my girlfriend. She's purple.
My sister.
Yeah.
Why don't you come in?
Okay.
what do you do for a living?
I fashion clothing.
I do too. I think I love you.
Oh my gosh, you're so handsome. I love you too.
Never tell your sister.
What?
But until tomorrow.
Let's go get married.
No, no, it's too soon. Let's go look at dresses on the internet.
Look.
Oh, well, hello there.
Oh, hi.
I'm coming on in.
I really like strawberries.
They're my favorite fruit. I think I love you. Do you love me?
Yes.
There he goes! Oh.
My love!
Oh, I love you.
Hi, Bob, my love!
Hey, he's my love.
No,
hey,
mine.
Hey, Bob, he's mine, love.
Wait, what?
No, he's mine!
Got out of there. Oh, hi. Hi, bud. How are you?
Hi.
Oh, hi.
What are you doing up here in my annoying cousin's attic that I have no home, so she makes me live up here.
Oh, well, I have no home either.
What?
I think I love you now.
I do too.
Everyone, shut up. We have an announcement to make. We're in love.
Yes!
No!
I won't believe it!
No! No! I thought you were! You're mine!
Do you want to get married?
Yes.
Let's get married!
Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, bum, bum.
Do you, Potato Droplet, and you, Bob Bob, take each other? I don't know how this goes, but take each other as to be married or something. I don't know.
Yes, but my name is Susie.
I don't really care. I do too. I've never loved anyone so much. He hasn't said kiss the bride yet, okay? So just shut up. You may now kiss your other one. I've never cried so much in my life.
I never cried so much!
My life is ruined!
Great wedding so far.
Yep. So good!
So much drama!
I could kiss you!
We're sisters, don't do that.
Catch me!
Long live.
But can't you see I'm calling?
Thank you.
Sorry I'm late. So, do you have the stuff?
Yep, I got your stuff.
But do you have the money? What kind of stupid question is that? Of course I have the money.
Good.
The money's in the envelope. Okay then. It was a pleasure doing business with you. Yeah, you too. I'll be on my way now. Mm-hmm.